Paper number one is coupling of phosphorylation to electron and hydrogen transfer by a chemiosmotic type of mechanism by Peter Mitchell, published in the journal Nature in 1961. This was Mitchell's original paper, and he asked, what are electron transport chains? Peter Mitchell provides theoretical background to this question. He hypothesized that ATP was synthesized with electrons and hydrogen ions, or protons, were transferred across a membrane. Mitchell knew that his mechanism was fundamentally very different from the thinking of the majority of scientists at the time. His theory depended on an enzyme system that was organized at the molecular level. And this organized system would drive a chemiosmotic enzyme system that could synthesize ATP. Note that he thought that the mechanism for ATP generation was the same in both chloroplasts and in mitochondria. So, how did Mitchell's theory differ from conventional approaches in 1961? Conventional enzyme assays mix the components of the assays together. They put in the substrate, they put in the enzyme, they put in the cofactors, and if they work, there is a reaction such as a color change. Conventional assays don't rely upon the spatial positioning that Mitchell points to in his introduction. Many things don't rely on spatial positioning. For example, if we're going to make chocolate chip cookies, you take all of the ingredients and you put them in a bowl, mix them together, and put the dough in the oven, and you wind up with chocolate chip cookies. But sometimes spatial positioning can be important. For example, we just can't put the pieces of a truck together in a mixing bowl and expect to get a working truck. The parts of a truck need to be assembled properly in order and in space. Otherwise, you are not going to get a truck that works. Mitchell's chemiosmotic theory relied on the spatial positioning of component parts in the membrane. In order to understand Dr. Mitchell's paper, we have to point out notations that were different in 1961. SH2 stands for a substrate such as glucose. DPN stands for diphosphopyridine nucleotide. We would now call that particular molecule nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, or NAD. FP stands for flavoprotein. Your textbook will call this molecule flavin adenine dinucleotide, or FAD. Q stands for quinone. In mitochondria, you would find it in your textbooks as coenzyme Q. In chloroplasts, you would see it called plastoquinone. OH was written differently in 1961. In science, sometimes notations change over time, either slowly or all at once with new discoveries. This paper answers Peter Mitchell's first question: what are electron transport chains? Their component parts are organized in membranes. And because they are organized in membranes, spatial positioning is important.